Mom, story time with Dad. This is my favorite story time. Under the bed in my secret fort, and I'm gonna read. Mulan. Long ago and far beyond the Great Wall of China, a young girl named Fa Mulan lived with her family. One day, the imperious aide rode into town. The Huns have invaded China, he announced. Oh, no. One man from every family must serve in the imperial army. The man on the horse announced. Oh, no. Mulan's father felt it was his duty to join the army, even though he had been injured in an earlier battle. That night, he began to practice some fighting moves, unaware that his daughter Mulan was watching. Oh. Suddenly, a pain from an old wound shot through his leg, and he collapsed and fell on the floor. Mulan was behind the door, and she was like, oh no, oh Dad. She whispered to herself, he wouldn't be able to survive another battle. So she decided to disguise herself as a man. She's gonna make herself a man and take his place. She cut her hair, snip, 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 snip. Oh no, look at that long dark hair falling. She put on soldier's clothing. Oh, put on these boots and these pants and this long sleeve shirt. And left in the middle of the night on her horse, Khan. Da-dum, 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 da-dum. Come on, Khan. Yeah. And she rode alone that night. But Mulan was not alone. She was in the spirits of her ancestors. Sent her, whoosh, a tiny little dragon to protect her. And so they rode all night long. And they rode and they rode. And they rode. Mushu caught up with Mulan, and soon they arrived at the army camp. Mushu, the dragon, whispered suggestions on how to look more like a man. Show them how you walk like a man, he said. Show them you can walk like a man, he said. Shoulders back, chest high, feet apart, heads up, and strut. Oh, I don't think I can do this, whispered Mulan. Mushu told her, it's all attitude. You just gotta have some attitude. Boop, boop, boop. Mulan took a deep breath and gathered her courage and strode into camp. She looked ridiculous. But she did her best. When she tried to make friends with the other soldiers like Chin Po, Yao, and Ling, she ended up causing a fight. Oh, boop, boop. Was in total chaos when Captain Shing arrived. Soldiers! The captain shouted. Oh, here he comes, everyone. Everyone sprang to attention and pointed at Mulan. They all pointed at her. I mean, him. He started it, they said in unison. They all thought she was a cop. I don't need anyone causing trouble in my camp, Shing said to Mulan. Sorry, Mulan said. Then she remembered she was supposed to be a man and lowered her voice.
Did you hear that? I said, I'm sorry.
Captain Shang was a skillful leader and thought Mulan felt clumsy and inadequate. She worked as hard as she could, but she didn't want anyone to find that she was a girl. Shang led the recruits through a series of grueling training exercises to help them prepare for battle. One of the lessons involved retrieving an arrow from the top of a pole with a heavy bronze disc tied to each wrist. Ow! That hurts! Why didn't you try it? One represents discipline and the other strength. Shang said of the disc, you need both to reach the arrow.
But no one was able to do it. Oh my gosh, it was so hard. But finally, after several attempts, Mulan had an idea. Hey, I have a bright idea. She pulled the weights onto her wrists, looped them together, and used them to hoist herself to the top. She done it! She did it! Oh my gosh, she did it! Yay! So all the soldiers admired Mulan's determination, and even her new friend Chin Po, Ling Yan Yao, didn't even know that she was a man. After training, Shane led the soldiers to the Tung Shao Pass to meet the rest of the army. When they arrived, they discovered the army had been defeated and none of the soldiers had survived. Shane was especially upset when he realized that his father, the general, had been killed.
That's sad. I'm sorry, Mulan said, trying to comfort him.
Shane composed himself and turned to his soldiers. The Huns are moving quickly. We're the only hope for the emperor now. Move out, he ordered.
Oh, no.
Before long, the Huns discovered Shang and his troops. Hundreds of them raced over the mountaintop, firing arrows at Shang's small band of soldiers. Mulan seized a cannon and ran right toward the Huns. When she almost reached the leader, Shan Yu, Mulan aimed the cannon above his head. The rocket hit the mountain behind him and caused a huge avalanche. Snow tumbled down quickly, burying the enemy.
Yay! She got him. I mean, he got him. Mulan's a he, it's not a she. Nobody knows. Shh, nobody tell. She's doing a good job. Oh, Mulan had been wounded. Oh no, but she was able to jump on her horse and pull Shang away from the snow just before he was buried. As Qin Po and the others helped him to safety, Shang looked at Mulan with admiration. Ping, you are the craziest man I've ever met. For that, I owe you my life, he said. From now on, you have my trust. But Mulan's wound had to be treated. It was the soldiers.
Then that's when they discovered she was really a girl. I mean, yeah, she wasn't a guy. At that time in China, Mulan's deception was punishable by death. Shang spared her. A life for a life, he declared. My debt is repaid. He told her she was not allowed to continue with the other soldiers. Dejected, Mulan watched the troops march away, leaving her alone with Mushu, her dragon, and Khan, her horse. With a heavy heart, she confided in the dragon. I should have never have left home. I just wanted to do things right so that when I looked in the mirror, I would see someone worthwhile. But I was wrong. I see nothing.
You risked your life to help those people you love, Mushu the dragon said. But don't you worry. Things will work out. Don't you worry, Mulan. Things will work out. Don't you worry. You will see. Things will work out and you will see. Okay, so she was sad, but he was trying to comfort her. And then guess what happened? She realized that Shang Yu and a few of the Huns had survived. Racing on horseback to the Imperial City, Mulan found Shang and told him what she had seen. You don't belong here, he replied. Go home. You have to believe me, said Mulan. But Shang wouldn't listen. Soon the Huns seized the Emperor and ran into the palace. Mulan turned to her friend for help. Qin, Po, Ling, and Yao tried to break down the palace door. It was no use. Hey, I have an idea, Mulan said. Eager for the help of her quick-thinking friend, the soldiers let Mulan dress them as women.
Oh my gosh, now the guys are dressing like girls. That's what? Oh my gosh. And then they used sashes from their dresses to help them climb the palace columns. Shang realized that Mulan was trustworthy and joined their effort. Once inside, they attacked the unsuspected Huns, the bad guys, pretending to be girls. They don't know how to do anything like a man, but guess what? They did, and she's smart, and, you know, working together, we gotta work together. Whoever's smart, whoever's brave, it doesn't matter if you're a guy or a girl, we just need to win and help ourselves win from these bad people. Together, Mulan, Shang, and the others knocked out the Han soldiers. Bam, bop, boop, bop, bam, bop, boop, bam, boop, bop, oh, and rescued the Emperor. Then Shang went after Shang Yun, furious that the Emperor had escaped, and Han, the leader, drew his sword. You took away my victory, Shang Yun growled at Shang. No, I didn't. Mulan did. I did. She pulled back her hair so Shang Yu would recognize her and Shang's life would be spared. The soldiers from the mountain, the Hunlu cried. He began to chase her. You! It's you! Leading Shang Yu to the top of the palace, Mulan grabbed his sword and pinned his cloak to the roof. Mushan shot toward him on a rocket. The little dragon jumped to safety just before the rocket blasted Shang Yu into a tower of fireworks. Pop it up, pop! Little dragon is so helpful. After the battle, the Emperor approached Mulan. I have heard a great deal about you, Fa Mulan, he said. You stole your father's army, ran away from home, impersonated a soldier, deceived your commanding officer, dishonored the Chinese army, destroyed my palace, and you have saved us all. Mulan
We owe you. He bowed to Malone in gratitude, stunned everyone else, and they all did the same. See to it that this woman is made a member of my council, the emperor told his aide. Malone was honored, but she knew she needed to return home to her father and her dad. Then take this to your family. You will know you have done for me. The emperor said, handed her a pendant with the crest with his crest in it. Then he gave her Shen Yu's sword, and this so the world will know you have what you have done for China.
Oh my gosh, she got a sword and the emperor's crest, and she saved China. Oh, Mulan thanked the emperor, thank you, and she said goodbye to her friends. Goodbye, thank you everyone. She hugged them, and they hugged her and gave her a handshake. It was time for her to go home to her father's. At home, Mulan presented the emperor's pendant and Shang Wu's sword to her father. They are gifts to honor the Fa family, she explained and bowed her head. He put them aside and hugged Mulan. The greatest gift and honor is having you for a daughter, he said. Shang had followed Mulan home. He realized that his feelings for her had grown. She had been very curious, and he admired her for her. She is courageous. Mulan invited Shang to stay for dinner. He and her family celebrated, delighted everything had turned out so well. Oh my gosh, it's so nice to be home, Dad.
I'm so proud of you, daughter.
Check out more Sir Herbert Sneaky's podcast, Enchanted Readings, and check out some of his books. And thank you for listening.